from email notifications on our cell phones to brief moments of forgetfulness. Interruptions are everywhere and every day. While sociologists and linguists have studied them in practical interactions, literary and performance scholars have ignored their aesthetic iterations. My work considers them from this viewpoint, dividing them up not only into their comprising elements, but also dividing them into their distinct types. Through my study, I reveal information about power relationships and authorial style. My dissertation illuminates how the aesthetic, the everyday becomes aesthetic, and the aesthetic helps us to comprehend the everyday. Interruptions are made of three parts: premise, rupture, and continuation. A premise is a statement or an idea that has the expectation of a conclusion. A rupture is when a conversant speaks out of order or when an action occurs that halts the premise from reaching that conclusion. The continuation is what happens next. Either the premise reasserts itself and ends, the rupture may dominate over the premise, or the rupture and the premise might coalesce into a synthetic new conclusion and expectation. I argue for two important aspects of this aesthetic phenomenon. First, attending to interruptions means attending to the power structures both within and around a text. Interruptions are about relationships, and relationships encode dynamic systems of power. Through these structures, readers, audiences, and critics can reconsider the balance of power not only among characters within a play, but also between an audience and a performance, or a reader and a text. Secondly, interruptions reveal aspects of authorial style. In this study, I place Shakespeare into conversation with two of his contemporaries, Ben Jonson and John Fletcher, revealing their unique usages of interruptions. Shakespeare, for example, gives interruptive power to the audience through dramatic irony. We always know more than the characters on stage know. Jonson carefully controls his interruptions as an author, never allowing the many ruptures to overcome the premise. Finally, Fletcher radically moves away from the others as he allows ruptures to dominate, creating unexpected outcomes. Studying interruptions theorizes practices that connect characters, playwrights, audience members, and readers through power relationships that are always already ruptured moments of contact. And while I would like to speak further, thank you.